Hey all, this is Xenoxis, and this is the Legion Comms with Xenoxis. Yes, I'm starting it outside of the game, just so I don't have to, go out of the game, and everything, checking the volume, checking the microphone. That's good, that's working properly. And now we just need to go in on Battle.net and start up the game. So, yesterday I recorded, of course, the episode 28, as you can see here. Now, of course, these ones, the restoration and the balance, and if it all, like, the restoration and balance was recorded in December, and we're going to be uploading in January, but they were delayed. Episode 24 and 25 was delayed with the upload to the RE2 remake, Let's Play, basically. So those were meant to go up in January, basically. And of course, there is a bunch of stuff now that I'm probably going to prioritize uploading these, because we're getting to the end of the month. So, so then I can be ready for the things, And then, of course, the last day, I'm going to wait, with doing the priest, until I get the priest up, And, of course, I don't know how long I'm going to have my XP locked at 80, basically, on the priest, because I want to do some PvP and stuff that, and probably some more PvP as well. Because, I have a lot of versatility on that character, so yeah. But first, before we start the main episode, I just want to log in here. I'm just going to check and see if the thing has proc'd. Because I am checking this now. I am going to start checking this now every bloody day, basically, so I don't miss out on it. But of course, the thing is, you cannot miss out on it a day without knowing, like, I kind of wish that you could have some kind of app, or like an app that you could have on a PC, since I don't have a phone yet. And everything, and yes, it says false like that there. When I use the, this is what the macro looks like, basically. This is the macro right here. Run, print, quest flag, blah blah blah, and that's supposed to be the one for the, and I'm using the artifact right now, basically. And let me actually use those things, because they are transmuted into the artifact. So the thing is, I don't know if the locations is fixed, if it can only show up in gold piles, or if it can be absolutely anywhere. Because that's the thing that I don't know. And of course, it is still worth, going here. Oh, whoops, I missed something. Because I do want to still, mine stuff, because I still need to raise my... Wait, where exactly is... Oh, right. It's just a fill slate, yeah. But I still need to raise my, Legion Designs things, basically. I need to do the quest for that. What quest is it that I have for Yule Crafting? Let me check here, Yule Crafting, someone that knows about Banner on this. Ooh, Stormheim, ooh. Damn it. I hate when this happens, when you're like recording. And I know there was an invasion up, before I went to bed yesterday, or today, basically. Because I know that on certain characters, of course, this one I've already gotten the mountain and everything, but on the characters that needs to do Stormheim, it's really, really good. And I mean, it's a really good XP bonus as well for the ones that they need to basically do it, It's a really, really good XP bonus. Basically, you also want to, mass prospect with the whole thing here, with the whole mass prospect thing, because then you can gain several games, basically. And I believe this shield can only show up in specific locations. But the thing is, it can show up false unless you're at a very, very specific position. And I don't know if it is that it's that it doesn't work properly or whatever, I know I should have taken a dump before I started, but sometimes it's not guaranteed that I will, have to take a dump, sometimes it's just that I feel like gassy and stuff that, and I just need to fart a bunch, and stuff that, and almost shit my pants. And that's just because my poop can get very, really bad, and that's just because of the IBS and stuff that, of course, the coffee can kind of make it worse, sometimes, but yeah. And I still feel after the whole spicy thing and stuff that, but yeah. So I went with something simple, I'm using mostly the pieces of the Praetorium guard set, because the shoulders are like Praetorium stuff that, and the helm that you get, this helm, that's one of those things that actually feels like a more unique like Azerite piece, because it actually has a bit of a more to a design to it, the fact that, oh, it's very cool in spite, I really, really like this helm, by the way, yes, it's the whole ridiculous thing with whole horns and everything, and stuff that, but I mean, aside from the horns, I feel like it's pretty functional. Like, it doesn't need these parts. Like, it could be cut off here, basically. But then the spikes. I mean, like, there's a thing with spikes on helmet, really, like a wonder, like, you know, like I know, you know, like, oh, you would never use your helm in combat or whatever, you know, but what if, you know, like, in, or like in a fist fight, you fucking have a helm and you can fucking Danish head someone, or like, it's called Dansk Skull here in Sweden, that's when you, like, you know, use your head, you know, when you attack or whatever, you know, it is, but yeah. So I don't know all the places that it can show up in. Like, I've started to try and look everywhere, you know, and stuff that. And then, you know, like, that thing with it showing up as false doesn't, I feel that it doesn't really, really mean anything, because, like, there have been people who have said that, oh, I've had it shown up as, you know, like, false, and then I went inside and then the thing was just there, you know, and stuff that. And, you know, it just feels like, you know, like, and I don't know if it can only show up where the golden piles are, or if it can, like, show up at other places too. Because I think that I've seen pictures where it's up against the wall here, you know, and stuff that. And it's just like, what if I missed it sometimes because I only checked the golden piles and I didn't check everywhere else? Like, what if it can spawn inside here, you know, like, you know, and stuff that. And the thing is that I really, really wonder, like, okay, how is highest chance? Because on the mage, it didn't take long for the thing to trigger, like, the portal and stuff like that, which gave you the frost one. Because I got an all the second on the mage, and even waiting for that sheep to show up in the mage or the hall, that happened. And the thing is, I played my mage less than I played my warrior. That's the main weird thing. Like, I've been logged in on my warriors many more times, and I still haven't seen the shield pop up a single time. But on my mage, I did get the frost one, and the frost one, by the way, that requires you to have the portals, and then you hear like a noise coming from the portal when you go in the stairs. And then there is another one, which is the with the sheep thing, and one of the steps requires a sheep to spawn inside the order hall, and that thing is also like a daily chance occurrence, you know. And same thing with the whole portal thing, and those both of those things have happened, even though I've been logged in less on the mage. You know, stuff that, so I'm just like, you know, like, you know, it's like, you're like, what the hell, man, you know, it's like. But I don't know, and I thought that, oh, maybe you have to do something, like, maybe, oh, maybe if you kill mobs or whatever, maybe, you know, it increases the chances. Maybe it has to do with the cobalt accelerating it up, because why does it count as a quest? Why is it a quest flag? The thing is, if it is a quest flag, then that must mean that there are actually some kind of hidden, you know, requirement for you to trigger it, right? It has to be some kind of hidden requirement, right? Doesn't it? It? Okay, that's just where the exits are. Okay. Oh yeah, my stomach is a bit bad. And I don't know if it can spawn up here or not. The mom's so fucking gassy, like, I mean, the pizza didn't help either that I had during the weekend as well, so yeah. And it's just like, you know, it's a bit annoying when you have a sensitive stomach like this, you know, like with all obvious things, you know. And other things that you should, like, avoid, like spicy food and stuff like that, but, you know, like, I can't help it, you know, like, because, you know, like, thing, you know, like, it's just like, so yeah. Hello, I do start a bit tired still. I didn't sleep super much and stuff there, but sometimes it's just that I can get away with sleeping a little bit. And there was one day also when I slept with him, like, wearing my, I'm still wearing my clothes, you know, and just laying on the bed and stuff that, so yeah. I just always want to, like, double check, just, you know, to make sure, you know, and stuff that. And the thing is, I think that, oh, that it's, you know, like, it being a daily thing, like, oh, maybe it is daily, but what if it's not, you know, and stuff that, that's the whole thing, you know, like, you know. And then, like, if you look up threads, you know, there are people, you know, who contradict each other, you know, and stuff that, and there are people who are like, oh, I had a macro show up as being false, but then I went inside, and then it was just there, you know, and stuff that. But then it's the question, like, where can it show up, like, can it show up everywhere in the cave system, you know, like. And what if it could actually show up in the other part, in the actual dungeon? Like, what if it could drop inside the dungeon? You know, that is something, you know. You know, so yeah. I mean, wait, do completing these give Valashar rep when the Valashar thing is up? Because I would really want to try and get the Valashar rep to a certain level, of course. Wait, let me just kill some of these actually. And yeah, I went into Prospect pretty recently actually. I think it's Prospect, they have actually changed quite a bit, to be honest. They finally made it so Devastate is not in the same as Indomitable. Indomitable is slightly different now, because I believe before it was your stamina, it affected, it wasn't just like max health plus 10% or whatever, you know. Of course, Never Surrender, that's kind of not really different, except it, I don't think we would call that. That is really interesting, the bolster thing though. Last stance cooldown is reduced by 60 seconds, and the addition, it causes you to block all melee attacks. Which, you know, reducing it by 60 seconds means that you can use it every 2 minutes, and it lasts for 15 seconds, and for the first 50 seconds, you know, you gain more health, you gain 15% more or 30% more health, and basically you block all melee attacks. So if there's a boss with melee attacks, you know, like, that's the thing that I think that warrior should always be the number one choice when it's something with melee attacks. Like, there is, I would say this, that I can understand, you know, like, in early WoW, you played a class, you didn't play like a spec. Now it's more like you're playing a spec, but I kind of wish that we would make the specs more. Yes, there should be some abilities that you have access to as all of the specs. But then there should be abilities that should be exclusive and stuff like that. Like, I definitely think that Combat Rogue or Outlaw Rider, like, what if they would actually turn Outlaw into an actual tank? There have been people that have been wanting a Rogue tank. You might say, oh, but what about the Outlaw DPS players? Yeah, but here's the thing, right? You can still make a tank deal somewhat decent damage, at least, you know, and maybe make them slightly worse at tanking, you know, and stuff like that. That's the thing, like, tanks shouldn't always be doing bad damage, you know. That's the thing, like, I can understand, like, oh, tanks shouldn't be doing DPS damage, but, you know, if a tank is overgearing a DPS, then they should definitely be able to, like, out damage a DPSer, you know, and stuff that, especially, you know, like, a tank, like, some tanks should be really, really good at whole AoE thing, you know, level AoE damage, you know, because, you know, like, damage equals kind of threat, you know, so yeah. Maybe it's the burrowing spiderling that does what I need to get it to appear. Now, the thing is, the reason why you kill these is because these things can drop the materials, actually, when you mine them. It's not always 100% guaranteed. And I believe it increases when you increase your skill. So. But yeah, the question is it the kobolds that actually... is it the kobolds that actually make the thing spawn, you know, and stuff like that? Like, I thought about, oh, maybe if I kill enough, you know, it's... You know, but this is also something I realized, that this place is very good for getting the love things. For getting the love things to show up, like... The drop rate, especially from the kobolds, is really, really high for this. Especially at the level I am at currently, basically. So yeah, this is probably not going to be the main episode, this is just going to be a shorter one. I'm going to make this a maximum of half an hour, because there are some things that I want to check in. I want to make sure I get a little bit more of these so I can hand them in. Because I handed in all of them yesterday. And I should actually start queuing for the... Let's queue for the... Count chemical thing. The main problem is, of course, that when you... when you use Devastate, then it replaces a certain attack, it replaces Devastate basically. But yeah, but that of course has a chance to reset the cooldown on Shield Slam, so you could definitely make, like, you know, with Punish, Shield Slam increases damage and reduces enemy damage against you, you know, and stuff like that. And I thought about, you know, taking Crackling Thunder, you know, because of the Thunder Clap radius, you know, and stuff like that. So yeah, there are some really, really interesting things. And Rumbling Earth, of course, is really, really good, you know, like reducing the cooldown on your thing. Now keep in mind that it's fairly easy to get here as a warrior, you know, especially since you can just go to your you can just go to the class over the hall and then basically. Let's do this. nice. Oh yeah, that's a problem. I can get rid of this potion because that's intellect. Let's think this one, strength and agility. Versatility one I can keep. I think there was something else I could get rid of, but I forgot exactly what it was. Yeah, let's get rid of preserved holy here. Let's get rid of potion of slow fall also, so I can have inventory space, and let's get rid of the beta tar just, you know. Yeah, they will soon activate. Here we go. Okay, use that, use this. I don't know if I'm tanking good or not, you know, that's the main problem, you know, like, when you haven't tanked in a while, it's just, you know, like, because the ammo around a lot for being a tank, but that's just the way my style kind of is. Did I ding? No. Someone else did. Alright, and I'll leave the group. There we go. So it's a pretty lucky, you want to do it with characters that are over under 10, of course, obviously. Now where did the thing go? So that's like a little lower than us called, so we can get rid of that. We don't need that. And this was intellect, we don't need a lower stomach card either. Which is what I should have removed first. I was trying to look for those things, but yeah. I'm so thirsty, man. But didn't I get the... Didn't I get the box of chocolate? What the fuck is up with that? You received the item, it does say it. Oh, there it is. I'm just completely blind sometimes. Okay, so I'm at 40 now. That's pretty decent, at least. And they get another one of these. How many lovely shaman do I have? I kind of wish that these were stacked, so I have one, two. Wait, so let me do this here. So I have one, two, three. Four. No, I have three now. That's three right there. So I need four right every day. And yeah, I've gotten these to drop once as well. Okay, those are the lovely love rocket which you use for something. I think I can mass prospect now. Yes. Can mass prospect some shit? Oh, we can mass prospect too, even. And sometimes you can get unlucky with the stuff that you get, but sometimes it's very, very useful for making the other stuff once you get the recipes, basically. That's the thing to keep in mind, that, you know, like, sometimes it's just all about getting the correct recipe that came up with a new recipe. And I mean, the good thing about farming this is that you can also farm, you know, the materials and stuff that you can farm, the whole, you know, the whole things and stuff there. But I don't know all the places where the weapon can show up, you know, which is kind of the main problem, you know, that I have, you know, and everything. Of course, it is also worth killing these, because this counts as a thing that can drop the thing. See, they've got some lace stuff on them. It's pretty good. And the reason why I'm not using the cultural things is because I want to save up and make these staffs, basically. Make these to unlock them for, you know, because these staff look pretty pimping, you know. Although I really like this one. This one is very colorful. I mean, this one is, you know, with, you know, yeah. I mean, those staff looks really nice, you know. Now, if only those staffs were, like, you know, also count as maybe cosmetic or something like that. Because, you know, imagine, you know, like, if it would not have a level requirement. I can understand because, you know, what their level they are. But it would be cool if they made a staff like that. That it could be, like, that you could have, like, at a certain, you know, thing. Actually, let me go to... Yeah, let's just go to Lionhorn Enclave. And I can just log out of there, basically. Yeah, I have replaced this now, basically. And yeah, I mean, this still works at 115, by the way, keep that in mind. But yeah, it of course gets replaced by this, you know. The thing is, I still need to respec for that one. But I think kind of replaces a bit like this. Except, of course, this blade storm increases your movement speed by 10% and damage on by 2% for 6 seconds, increases periodic and stacking up 6 times. And this, of course, by blade storming every 0.9 seconds, you gain 5% movement speed and 83 strength stacking and that's 6 seconds. So, you know, that's decent. It's not as powerful as the Great Storm sign. And the horse effect also stacks, by the way, so yeah. But maybe they will make legendary Azerite gear or something like that eventually, or something. So yeah, wizardry colognes we don't need. We need about water colognes section. Okay. Should I make it? Yeah, I'm gonna actually do this here. Make that our home. And I'll go back to the... I'm just gonna slay the elite thing here. Because I wanna check if I get Valachal rep or not. Because these might be increased because of these being elites, basically. Like, these might be the ones that are like 350 rep or whatever. And if these are 350 rep, then that's really, really useful to do, actually, if it's 350 rep. And it's really recommended that you do, basically. So yeah. It's good that Wardens is one of the ones. I mean, there are certain ones that require, you know, I have on Twitter, I posted about. Yeah, Odin, you're not perfect either. Odin is the fucking... It's probably the reason why Helia went all crazy. Oh, come on. Okay, come on. Nice, very nice. Why do they chase the whole horde? Okay, that's 150 rep, really? Okay, I mean, it's some rep, you know, and, you know, it's still worth doing, you know. I mean, because nether shards are still important, you know, most of that, you know what I'm saying? I definitely want to do this for the rep, though, because you need Exalted to get one of the things. You need that for the Fury thing, basically. Alright, it can spawn here, I think. Alright, maybe I should rebuff actually. There we go, and then we need to. Where's the food buff? I thought I had a full buff. Okay. I've got both shoulders and I got a cloak that can of course test here because sometimes it could have a chance to roll into a like a thing with speed on it, especially like that's what makes like grinding for certain gear pieces still worth doing, you know. And of course these ones could also give some stuff. Subtenagle form. I mean I know that you could do those things on Mythic already, like you could do it on regular Mythic difficulty already back in Legion if you play the correct classes or if you have like good enough like legendaries and stuff that. Now I am of course trying to save up for a certain specific legendary, even if the legendary effect won't work, you know. Like especially if I can't get, you know. So we destroy these. Eh? Alright, then this as well. Okay. I just basically just want to do all the quests here, basically. Like, I'm not gonna do the whole, you know. Now, the best core thing that can show up, of course, is the... what do you call it? The best thing that I feel can show up is the... I forgot what you call it even. Seriously. I'm gonna do this. Sockwave is good. Really good bad way because of the stun, you know. So we need to wait for the thing to appear. Alright, that maybe was my only food item, maybe. It was... Alright, the guy's here. Okay, a little bit more. Nice. Yeah, that wasn't that much, but you know it adds up, you know. Ooh, heroic inspiration, huh? Also, I think it's by 15%, haste increase by 24%, that's nice. Yeah, and here you could have gotten like the thing with the using sheet slam because you're blocked by 131 and the damage of a sheet slam. So when you have something that can overlap the effect, like overlapping is actually good because that makes it so that you can always have the effect up, basically, if you can overlap the effect. That means that you can basically keep it on forever, basically, if you just use it enough. And I really like the fact that you can get quite a lot of damage if you go with like whole shield stemming. And the shield stemming is always something I've liked, you know, that's the home same kind of thing with like throwing the shield and stuff that as a pot paladin. Although I miss some of the old school pot paladin tanking, you know, like and stuff that, but the main problem with, you know, with old school ass tanking is, you know, like, is this the cave ones? Yes, it is the cave ones. Quick to do with someone, you know, that they can, you know. Because I know how frustrating it is if people get attacked, you know, when they're doing stuff like this, you know. Like I always try to avoid attacking horde. Well, it depends on the character, of course, obviously, because certain characters got their own playing reasons for doing certain things, you know. I really like Shockwave, by the way. Like, Shockwave doesn't deal a lot of damage, but Shockwave is really useful to use. Okay, so last one now. No, second to last one. Okay, I need just to kill something quickly. Okay, so two left. How much was that? That was 75, okay. Ugh. Yeah, I know, but I don't want to do that, salt man. You don't need to. Every single time. Come here. Oh, that's nice. Sweet. Nice. So that's 150. Okay, so I will be up to almost 19,000. It's pretty funny when people try to be like, oh, lol, look at her, like her smoker voice and blah, blah, blah. Yeah, but you know that she had an operation and that's why she sounds that way, you know. Fucking unsensitive pricks. I know. Candy butt, what? I mean, okay, if you want to put candy in butt, that's something you can do. I mean, but only if you eat it afterwards, no. Running really slowly towards something. Running so slow. That doesn't help against the nose right now. Incapacitate effects and also you're better too. This of course can drop the reroll cost, but yeah. But you also need to slay proper demons as well. And of course one of the pets on named Brody, you know, that makes them wait. There we go. Drana Heal is actually something I really miss on the Light Forge and stuff that. But for my character it used to make sense totally that my character would become like Light Forge and stuff that, you know. Especially RP wise. Are the demons nearby? Wait, can I even spawn up here? Oh, we can, I think. Yeah. The thing is, for people that do this and it takes a long time, that's just often because they don't explore everywhere because they think that, oh, this is the only place that has the demons, but you know, like. Then you go and explore and then you find out, you know, that there are demons in a lot of places. Dum brum brum. How much was that? Okay, so almost 18,000. 500, which is a decent amount. Okay, so that's Halls of Valor. I wonder how doable it is on Mythic. I'm just gonna test to see how viable it is, because blue quests like this, Dungeon Quest specifically, gives you a lot of rep, if I remember correctly. I think they give 500. And of course they did boost, you know, the rep from certain things, you know. But the thing is, you know, I really hate the fact that people didn't want mounts in Paragon boxes anymore. Because here's the thing, right? Like, a lot of people are like, oh, but it's so annoying to get mounts, because they feel like they're entitled to everything. And here's the reason why it was good. The fact is that you come back to Legion and do Legion content even when you're max level now, because you might still be missing some mounts that you can do, so you still have an incentive to do world quests here, and they still give decent amount of gold and decent amount like of reward all resources, you know, and stuff that. And then, you know, like, you can, you know, if you want to get a full legendary collection, you're gonna have to work for a while, you know, and stuff that. And, you know, like, you know, depending on, of course. And of course, that you will just get legendaries naturally. I believe you can still get legendaries no matter what your level are, basically. You know, as long as you, you know, as long as you dance a salsa lite senare. And that's of course the raid. And this is of course the onion. There we go. And this should be mythic. And I believe mythic shouldn't be that bad. I mean, yes, our gear isn't the greatest, really, or anything, but still. So yeah, we will see here. It depends on the damage they deal. They do a little bit of damage, but it's not really that bad, to be honest. As long as I, like, manage my pulls and stuff that. Because, I mean, like, I could solo certain places, kinda, at max level, backdooring Legion on my Paladin and stuff that. Although I never got really the good legendaries, I did get one of them, but that was like the one of the good things for the Paladin. Yes, that was a problem with the... But the thing is, imagine if the system would have been from the very, very start, the thing. Oh yeah, and it's because of this stun thing. That's something that also makes the warrior so very, very useful. The fact that you have your stuns and stuff that, and then you... One thing that you can use, for example, also is you can use this. You can use Intimidating Shout, for example, to stun them and stuff that. Like, you have a lot of short CC tools, but that can also work as interrupts in order to, like, interrupt their spells and stuff that, which is, you know, which is always useful, of course. Doing the heal is also quite important as well. Yeah, I still have the attack power increasing. So, did we have another food orb? Is there food that I can make? I could make beta tar, which is not greatest really. Maybe I shouldn't have deleted my beta tar that I had before. I mean, it's not really that useful, but I thought I had gotten the other thing. Oh, I don't have any food item at all. Which is a bit bad actually, because this is that, you know, like, but of course our health. Oh yeah, this fight can be a bit annoying here. I think I can actually pull like this. Let's use spell reflector. Let's pop all the cooldowns. We need to deal damage here basically. Yeah, I'm gonna try and do this here. Okay, so I died because of the lightning there, but that won't, you know, cause me to give up or anything, but, you know, because that's the thing that when I try to solo with back when I was at 1 or 10, for example, when I tried to solo on my paladin, you know, stuff that was something, you know, that was a bit, I was saying, like, the thing is for the people that do, you know, like, solo mythics or, like, higher mythic pluses back in Legion, you have to have very, very specific legendaries and then very specific, like, you often needed pieces with leads on them, but this is pretty good. We got one of them down at least, so you know, like now it will be easier, kinda. And what I think we need to do is we need to kill the spellcasters. See, that's the main problem, that you have them doing the whole stun thing. So I need to get away from the stun thing actually. Come on, save me. I think we got one of them at least. I think we got another one. Yeah, that is the storm drake that is the problem, I think. If I would have... Oh damn, I forgot I had the unbending potion. Let's pop on Unbending Potion and let's nuke down the dragon. I'm gonna try and... Okay, I can't see the dragon, so we're gonna have to... Yeah, it's that thing that stuns you. And I think you need to basically get away from where the ball is. Come on, we almost got him. Oh, spamming, 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 spamming! Come on. I know I can do this. I know I can do this. I need just a little bit more damage. Stun him. It's the fucking lightning, man. Alright, I forgot to... If I would have had that to shout up there, I think I would have done it, actually. So the thing is that I need to stun him and stuff there, but I think I can probably try and kill these off maybe. Maybe it's just that these adds just that little bit of damage that they need, you know, whatever, you know. And the thing is, if I can kill off one of them, then I should be able to gain health back, basically. I'm gonna jump away after this here. I'm gonna cast Reflect here. I about how long the spell effect lasts at all. You know. There we go, nice. And now we can try and... You don't want to be near the lightning though, which is the main problem. Avoid the lightning breath, that's the thing that really does a lot of damage. Cause spell reflect, charge in, that. Nice, no problem. It's just that you need to kill the other mobs, and killing him on his own is not that big of a problem. The main problem is of course his lightning, but I think that we have many times just taken lightning breath straight to the face, and that's the main problem that we haven't been able to. See? I mean, that's often the thing also with Mythic Dungeons. That it's not necessarily the... It's not the bosses that are often hard, it's like the actual mobs and stuff that... Wow. Living Action Potion. I wonder if that still works. Makes the immunity stun and immunity bearing freaks. Okay, I probably should have healed up fully before I challenged him. Heimdall. Which I'm guessing is based upon Heimdall actually. But this is bad, I didn't see that. I forgot about that. Oh, damn it! I should have paid attention, man. I didn't fucking pay attention. I'm so bad, man. Maybe it's just that I'm tired, you know, and stuff like that. Like, yeah, I know, excuse, but still. Alright, then we have the Winter Veil cookie at least. I thought that was percentage healing, but apparently not. But it's still probably worth just getting just a small buff at least. And there's still stats plus 10. And then, of course, we need a battle shot. I definitely think that like there could be things that they could remove that wouldn't make sense for a prot palette or for a prot warrior, for example, like, you know, like, and maybe things should be a bit... I also think that, you know, Pain should get some kind of graphic to it. Like, the thing is, Last Stand looks cool because it looks like, you know, you become blue and everything, but the thing is, when you pop, you know, Pain, you don't really see anything, you know? So yeah, and you need to pay attention to when the dragons show up, basically. It's what you need to be doing. So you kind of want to hold him in the middle, kind of. Not a problem. And then you have to avoid these here. Yeah, I didn't avoid it in a good way there. That was a bit bad. You saw how much damage I took from that. That was basically the thing that I took damage from there. A lot of damage was basically from that one specific thing there. And this is of course where the Drana healing comes in here. Which is really useful, that's basically what... I hope they won't nail the middle here. So let's be over here first. I have to pay attention if it's coming here. I know, I have taken a lot of damage, it's really bad. Main problem is that I did take a full, like, lightning hit. If we wouldn't have done that before, then we would have been at a lot higher health. The main problem is I do have no self-healing, you know. If I only had Last Stand available, then that would have been good. And that was pretty decent, but still it's the whole lightning thing that gets me. Like, if I don't get hit by the lightning, I would have had more than another felt there. Should I give up already? I don't know. Up there. just, you know, yes, I know I could go into normal difficulty or heroic difficulty and just rush to, you know, stuff that I finish the quest that way, but, you know, like, I'd rather, you know, do it when I can, you know, stuff that. And I kind of know what legendary I would want as well. And, of course, you know, you don't really need the legendaries, you know, stuff that. And then once you want 20, you can just you can just immediately solo it at that point, basically. So, yeah, something to keep in mind. So sell that as well. So the thing that you want, basically, like the legendary you want, I think, is like, let's see here. So I think I can I sort protection? Yes, I can. I forgot if it's protection or not. The Magnus Opus is, of course, really, really good, but the main problem is that goes in the same slot. But the thing that is good with certain legendaries is that they have really, really good stats on them. Attacks, increase the damage done, and rage generated by your next. She's a Montana Clap, Destiny Driver. That one was cool. Intercept attacks grants you and your intercept target on absorb shield equal to 50% of the damage done. So the thing is, if you use that together with, if you use it together with Safeguard, intercepting a friendly target now also causes 30% of the damage taken to transfer to you. And if you stack that with Destiny Driver, that's a pretty good combo. System Generator is an additional 2 rates and reduce the remaining cooldown of Shield Wall. Which is like, something like that is just like, you know, Heroic Leap, yeah, Heroic Leap gains 2 charges. It's just pretty, pretty dope. Of course, all of the Battle Lord, of course, you know, but you can, of course, kind of earn that. That's not the ring you earn, right? Because the ring you earn from doing Argus is different. Do we have the quest for that even? Yeah. Signal of the Grand Army, yeah. Increases all healing done by 2% and all damage done by 2%. And of course, I really love the Netherite Crucible, by the way, you know, stuff that's, yeah. And of course, there are a bunch of those legendaries that are pretty nice, but of course, the legendaries can be very easily praised. But I also want to go. I want to go and do the whole. How long until that ends? 2 hours and 5 minutes. So that's pretty good. So we want to go to Stormwind now, and want to start handing in the stuff. Then I'm going to make the proper recording after that, the one with the actual episode with the Subtlety Rogue, which is episode 29 actually. So right, and the next series that I'm gonna start, as I've said, I'm gonna start it in September, the next series and stuff that, and probably, you know, like, there are, you know, let's plays that I need to finish also, but there was certain let's plays that I'm doing that I had on the old channel, which is the reason why I did those again, you know, like the Final Fantasy one, because the Final Fantasy 7 one was very popular, you know, and stuff that's, yes. So we need to hand in that Warion. Then we need this. We also need this. So we need to go to the place. And I forgot to do this yesterday, basically, crossing the town. And the thing is, since I have 40 already now, I can get very, very high amounts today. Then this, of course, you can finish that in any city, but this one, the Crossing the Crown, I believe you can only, it's only from Stormwind you can get that, so that's gonna be 5, so 10, 15, basically 15 more, so that's gonna be 55, and of course you have all the force that you can add in, you know, and stuff that, which is gonna be nice. You cost the Stormwind Core, which you have no use for. Although I believe I could give it to other people. Oh, that's a mage. Here you go, mage. how this buff here. Oh no, that increases on my own. I thought I could give it to other players. That would make sense, right? Because it's a lovely card, you know, or whatever, you know, like. Okay, so now we... should I do it that way? Yeah, I think I can do it this way. I'm pretty sure that I can do it this way. Because of course handing in all of those things are really, really important, and of course this one you can do in pretty much in any city, so we can finish it whatever the last city is we go to. And then we're going to Borealis. Because otherwise you have to go back to someone. You can of course just take the Arlan portal and to break the portals from there, but there are also portals in here. And then we can also finish up the thing. Because I think that I've sent them on a mission. And I still haven't gotten them back. Yeah, from Sidivastronar. You can of course go to Ironforge from here and Exodar. Which we should probably go to Exodar next. So we can go to... Alright, I'm gonna take the cooking thing here. Yes, I want cotton cooking, please. Thank you. Right. That's useful to pick up. What's this? This is... Yeah, because... now he tells you about this. The first dishes. Yes, and... And yeah, you need to do the things to be able to get it all. So then we go to the alchemy, inscription, mining. Just checking. Okay, that seems good. And then we have you crafting here. So that's gonna be at 50. It's gonna be the things. Okay, so it's if 50 is the next thing. So yeah. So we need a bunch of wool basically. Do I have fishing by the way? I do have fishing, right? I do have fishing. So yeah, let's get the fishing because the fishing is useful. Because we basically need the fishing to capture the things. Because getting the fish oil is very important. Yeah, let's get all of the fishing here. Why not? So, because you need basically the fishing to get the grill catfish, for example, and getting some of the stuff, you know, the aromatic fish oil that need stuff. Which is very useful. I'm gonna actually. I started to forge here and we forged the shoulders. I know I went with long story there, but that's mostly because of running dungeons that I'm gonna be doing on the character. Using shield slam, good. That can be really, really good though. Yeah, but that is good, it's done. You can heal up between packs basically. And I think the whole idea behind the Azerite system is actually very, very good because he has more customization. But the way to make that work is to make it more like a talent tree, which of course they are going to eventually make it more like artifact weapons and stuff there, but you know, like just like... But it's just like also it was like, you know, they didn't take feedback properly or whatever during a thing, you know, but that might have been, you know, that it's... Maybe it's really, really hard program, you know, that that's the thing we don't know, you know, like... You know, because, you know... I wouldn't be surprised by that, you know. So both of these are... Wait, can I recruit more? Yeah, and that's 29 minutes, okay. How high can I get percentage here? I would really love to get the bonus here. Let's test this one. And this one is 35. Both of these 135 then. Yes. But the thing is I would want to try and get higher, and I think I will get higher if I wait for the thing to be recruited basically. I kind of also wish that if you hadn't done this in a while, the whole island expedition, then the reward from it should be higher if you haven't done it in several weeks or whatever. Oh, don't they show up as a world quest anymore? The whole thing with the whole, you know, like gaining a certain amount per week or whatever, you know?